This is the Nameless Queen. After the shattering, our queen was blessed with the guiding grace of gold. Upon arriving to the lands between, she set forth to undo the atrocities committed by Queen Marika. To navigate this land, she concealed her intentions and true identity by mastering all fundamental powers this land could offer. Hiding in plain sight, she explored every region of this world, mastering the ways of combat and displaying her skill eloquently against all enemies in her path. Leaving an immense legacy of rumors and myths of the mysterious woman who wielded great knowledge and unmatched power. Once she had obtained all the necessary powers to slay the demigods and legendary foes, she returned to where her journey began and set forth to mend the Elden Ring and become Elden Lord.
I would describe the Nameless Queen as a hybrid build of utility and versatility. It uses a single set of core stats, but encapsulates almost every possible playstyle Elden Ring has to offer. The stats for this build focuses on three core elements: Dexterity for spellcasting speed, and for access to a great range of dex-focused weapons. Faith, to access a range of powerful, aggressive, and defensive incantations. And Arcane, again, to access a range of different weapons, and to also increase status effect buildup, such as bleed or poison. With this stat distribution, you can access 76 of the 101 incantations available in Elden Ring. And even more if you mix up talismans or have Godric's Great Rune activated. Due to the split stat distribution between Faith and Arcane, Dragon Communion Seal becomes our most powerful casting tool, giving it 303 incant scaling, making it incredibly powerful for every incantation type available. Same goes for weapons. The amount of incredibly powerful weapons this stat spread gives you access to is nothing more than impressive. It offers an immense variety of unique and interesting playstyles to approach every combat situation. Now, as I am showcasing the versatility and utility of this hybrid build, for each boss, I have used a different setup and playstyle to capture what this build is truly capable of. So, I won't be detailing anything further here. Rather, throughout the showcase, I will show and briefly explain what I used before each fight. Like my last video, I will again be facing the earlier bosses with underleveled weapons to intentionally increase the fight duration. In doing so, I subsequently highlight how truly powerful these setups can be if they were fully maxed out. So that's it. 15 unique playstyles or builds if you'd like, all available from one single stat spread. As always, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy the showcase. We start our showcase challenging Godric with a setup that focuses on pyro damage.
of all that is golden. And one day, we'll return together to our home, bathed in rays of gold.
Here, we have a Holy Lightning hybrid, which uses my personal favorite summon, just to balance out Renala's phase 2 summoning spam. Sticking with Caleb's theme of rot, we focused on status effect buildup to conquer the mighty Radahn. For the ancestor spirit, we exploited its weakness by focusing on ranged holy attacks, all made possible with increased intelligence from talismans and our physic. This is one of my favorite setups, a hybrid physical ranged stance breaker using aspects of the crucible. Usually I don't enjoy Astel, but this setup was seriously effective. we focused on the power of black flame spells to overcome the Lich Dragon's janky camera movement. Nothing exciting for this one. For Rykard, a level 0 Serpent Hunter with a focus on absorbing fire damage. focusing on frostbite infliction with a cold Arumi and frozen lightning, we froze Morgott at the foot of the Erd Tree. We exploited Mog's weakness with quick-hitting bloody daggers, but we did show him some respect during his Phase 2 transition. An agile bleed setup with an increased focus on stamina regeneration and blood flame incantations. It is the perfect setup to face EldenRing's most aggressive demigod, Melania, Blade of Mikkola. We're maximizing damage for the Fire Giant with Dragon Incantations and the Death's Poker. Here we have another stance breaker, which focuses on the power of pierce damage, the Dragon Lord's only physical weakness. Challenge Malekith with honor with a 5+ Bloodhound's Fang, one of my personal favorite weapons that carried me through my first playthrough. dual bloody warhawk talons were used to quickly overcome Godfrey's brute force attacks. Finally, we see the Nameless Queen wielding the most appropriate weapon for her final battle for lordship.
And so, the Nameless Queen began her reign over the lands between, establishing the long-awaited age of order.